Hello everyone, this is Shafiq from Knowledge Byte channel. So yesterday we discussed about VSDC free video editor. Today we are going to see another feature of this same software, which will be very useful when you are doing any video editing. So yesterday I just discussed about how to actually split different videos. Whereas today we are going to see how photo slideshows can be used to make certain videos. So let's move on now. So first, as usual, we have to open VSDC editor. Now we have to click new project. It should give a name to this project and click OK. It depends upon your resolution, like as I said, whichever the resolution you want, you can select. And this is something called as frame rate. Usually by default, the frame rate which is applicable for maybe all the display, be it PC or a laptop or a TV or mobile, whatever you take, we usually used to keep 30 frames per second. But if you have some maybe 4K display or Ultra HD display, then the frame rate will increase. But right now we don't want to make any changes to it, so we can keep as a default and click finish. Now if you want to insert different photos and try to make it in the form of a video, so for that very simple process you need to do, what you just have to do is there is an option called add image. Click on this option. Then you should go to any folder where the image exists. Let us see some sort of, maybe these two are some images. So whatever the images which is available, whichever the images you want, you can select those images and click open. Now you can see automatically those two images will be added over here. In case if you need any more image, you can go here again. You can add a few more images if you want, if you have any other images over there. So you can select some images. Click OK. Now you can see all the images have been added over here. Now after adding all these images, like how in PowerPoint we used to keep slight transition. A transition is nothing but some sort of animation effect which will be applied when one image changes over the other. So likewise here also lot of options are available. Animation options are available. So whichever the animation option you want, you can select that animation option and just drag and drop here. So while changing from this image to this image, automatically you can see in this preview that transition will be applied. So depending upon your choice, you can apply any sort of transitions for every image. Okay, so it can be from any type of transition. It need not be from only one type of transition. You can use a different type of transitions. And finally click apply settings. Now automatically in the timeline the image will be created in the form of a video. Now when you click play, automatically after a few seconds the image will change, and you can see here the images are changing. So it is something like, if you want to make a simple video, then we are using this type of images. Not only images, even if you insert video, like I have inserted by mistake one video, so that's why it has become lengthy. So if you have inserted any video also, that video also will be collaborated along with the image. So not only with the help of images you can add you can make one video, but alongside you can select any video as well so that it will be appearing in the form of a video. Now if you want to give any title for this video, so you need to type some text over there. So for that, what you can just do is there is an option here that is a text option. Click here and click OK, and you need to draw a box like this. So for drawing box, if you want to type any name, you can just type over here Supermoon, something like this you can type. And then you have to you can see here above, you can select any font, you can select any size, font size. And then if you want to do bold, you can do bold or italic, whatever you want. Okay, then you can give text color as well. So whichever the feature you want to use regarding the text, you can use it. And then you just click on this and you can drag and keep wherever you want. So even along with the image, the text will also appear, and you can use this text over the video. Now below you can see another layer has been created for text. Now this text, up to which part of the video if you want to make it appear, you can adjust it. Just you have to bring the cursor like this. When the arrow mark appears over this timeline, you just have to drag and move up to where or which position you want the text to appear. So you can decide on it. So after that position, automatically the text will disappear. So till then the text will appear as it is. Now you can see here, even when the second image changes or third image changes, the text is still there, because till the position where I have dragged, the text will appear. So afterwards, after the timeline surpasses that particular thing, then what will happen, the text will disappear. So you can see here the text has been disappeared. So this way you can add as many text as you want, depending upon your the type of video. I mean, not only for title, you can even give it as a caption as well. That is what is given here. So if you want to keep a caption below, so you can or maybe like subtitles if you want to use in the video, you can use it. Okay, so these are all simple methods with which you can make, or you can convert video, I mean you can convert images into the form of video. Okay, so till then I'll wind up today's session. So maybe there are a lot more other features available in this same software, which we will discuss in our next episode. Till then, stay safe, take care.